Hi, I'm Vin with Boris Effects, and in this tutorial, we're going to take a look at working with BCC Stage Light inside of After Effects. Now, Stage Light is designed to augment the built-in lights within After Effects, but can also function as a self-contained 3D lighting system when used in supported non-Adobe hosts, for example, Vegas and Resolve. Now, in this tutorial, we're going to examine how to use Stage Light to add real-world volumetric lighting to a scene. We're also going to look at how it works in concert with After Effects built-in lights, how to manipulate those lights in 3D space, and how we can add animated lights to effect shots. So let's begin. All right, here I am inside of After Effects, and I have a clip here of a young woman dancing. Now right off the bat, this scene has some interesting lighting. The background is dark, there's a nice spotlight on the dancer, but I want to add some lights and even some atmosphere. To do this, I'm going to go to the Lights category and drag Stage Light onto my clip. When I do, I'm going to get this little light here that I can easily move around and reposition. Now if I go to the built-in light subgroup, I can enable up to 3 different light sources. For now, I'm just going to work with the first light, which by default is set to a spotlight, but I can quickly change that to a point light if I want. I can also adjust the intensity, the color. Since I'm going to leave it as a spotlight for now, my contextual controls are going to allow me to adjust the angle, feathering, and target. By playing around with these settings, I can easily create a light source above my dancer and one that matches the lighting pattern on the ground. I can even adjust the coloring, and you know what, let's make it a little bit more blue. Now to add atmosphere, all I have to do is go up to the smoke parameter and enable it. I can adjust the randomness of the smoke by adjusting the seed. Density controls how thick the smoke is, and the speed, of course, controls how fast the smoke animates. It's important to note that my stage light will illuminate the denser areas of smoke. Areas closer to the light source will reflect more light. So because of this, I want to make sure that I fine-tune my light intensity as well as the smoke density to prevent overexposure. That's looking pretty good. Now if you remember, I mentioned that I can create 2 additional light sources. By enabling source 2 and source 3, I can now position 2 additional lights towards the bottom of my scene. As before, they're going to default to spotlight, so let's open up the light source 2 and change the type to point. This will create an ambient point light instead of a cone. Increasing the intensity will make that light pop. And you know what? Let's make this one red. Now the trouble with a point light, at least in this scene, is that it currently looks less like a natural light and more like a flare, some kind of lens flare just floating there. To fix this, I can open up my point light controls, which are contextually active instead of the spotlight controls from earlier, and I can just go in there and feather it out a bit. Maybe reposition it a bit so that it looks like the light is coming from a source downstage. You know what, let's do the exact same thing with the other light. Once again, I'm going to adjust it to a point light, I'm going to change the color to a red, and I'm going to start feathering out that lighting. And there you go. Now if I toggle this effect off and on, you can see how easy it is to quickly add atmosphere and lighting to a scene to create some truly dynamic looks. Now I did all of this by adding lights to a scene, and this method is going to work great regardless of your host. But as I mentioned earlier, Stage Light is specifically designed to augment the built-in lighting in After Effects. What I just showed you can be done in any host, Vegas, Resolve, Media Composer, and others. But let's take a look at how I can use After Effects' own lighting system with Stage Light. So here I have a composition with a basic text layer. Now I could make my text out of something from Title Studio or maybe extruded text if I wanted, but to keep this simple, I'm just going to stick with some basic AE text. Now to add lighting and atmosphere to the shot, I could do exactly what I did earlier and create those 3 lights. But here's where things get very cool. As you can see, I've added 3 After Effects lights to my scene. They add a bit of color and shadow to the scene, and you can see that if I turn on Use Composition Lights, instead of the built-in lights we worked with before, Stage Light is going to switch to using my After Effects light. Now not only does this give me significantly more control over the look of my lights, but it also means I can create an unlimited number of lights for my scene. Remember, by default, Stage Light is limited to only the 3 built-in lights that come with it. But when working with AE's built-in lighting system, I can control as many lights as I want. This is a clear advantage to using Stage Light within After Effects. Now while I can still make adjustments to the individual lights in After Effects, I can also adjust them globally from within the Stage Light parameter panel because it works in concert with AE's lighting system. What this means is I can easily animate my lights using keyframes, null objects, and even expressions. Additionally, if I add a camera to my scene, the default settings will do fine, I can link this stage light to the camera animations. By enabling Use Comp Camera, any changes I make to the After Effects camera will be reflected in the lighting. This is very handy when dealing with multiple lights and complex effects. And as you can see, because we're working with AE's native lights and camera, I'm able to create these intricate lighting setups and camera movements that also preserve the depth of field and create complex animations all from within a single effect instance. Now, one of the things I like to do is actually use stage light not to light a scene, but to add to my particle effects. For example, here I've created a little animation, and I animated a null object in After Effects to spin as it moves across the scene. I then linked the After Effects light to it, and I'm using that light not only as my particle emitter, but also as my light source for stage light. This allows me to create a simple orb that animates along with my particle effect. And if I turn on the smoke effect, I can add some very cool volumetric lighting to really make things pop. But ultimately, that's all there is to it. I'm Vin Morreale, and for more great tutorials, don't forget to check out the Boris Effects website. Take care.